Hi, Ed here for MMORPG. We're back at RuneFest 2019. We're about half built on mana and things have kicked off proper. Obviously, those of you who are watching and have played RuneScape before will know who we're here with, but for everyone else, why don't you introduce yourself?
Yeah, I'm Dave Osborne. I'm lead designer for RuneScape, have been for 14 years, and this is my 10th RuneFest.
That is quite a few to go through.
I know, it's quite a chunk of them. I think it's 10, maybe 9. We'll see.
Jeez. So, you keep coming back for RuneFest, yeah. Obviously, but we're here at Farnborough Convention Centre. The event has grown massively over the last few years. Why do you think fans keep coming back to this?
Well, it builds a community, doesn't it? If you come back every year, then you see the similar faces, mm-hmm. You know, it's do a high five annually, you know, and to be honest, there's also the announcement bit. Uh-huh. You want to be there at the front row when things get announced, and there's a lot of swag. You know, you come for the swag, the merch. and maybe hug a few of our J-Mods, the people who work on the game.
And as well as getting to kind of meet and greet other people that play the game, there's a lot of activities that go on around here. I mean, behind us, we've got the food stall. That's just a necessity.
In the Wolfed event.
Yeah, exactly.
A burrito.
And we had a cooking event on earlier as well. We have the Dinosaur Derby. Why? It's more of a how do you feel that you managed to come up with such kind of different events, keep it fresh for everyone coming back.
I don't know why we do it to ourselves, because they're really hard to organise, but it's like, where every year you want to be doing something fresh. Uh-huh. And like, we haven't done crazy golf yet, why not? And you know, uh-huh. Like, then you start thinking, right, this is a dinosaur theme. We did Land Out of Time last year, mm-hmm. This year. And so it's like, how do you dress that? So, you know, you're putting your way through a Triceratops' legs. Obviously, you know, like a donkey derby. Well, maybe if we could change up the donkeys to dinosaurs. And it's the whole thing feels quite immersive. We've got a kind of one-to-one thing where you're going through the island almost as if you were going through the island in the game. Uh-huh. And that's always been really nice to do as well.
Is it always important to kind of keep that theme in the events that you have on with the game?
Or I think is it so. Just I think it's really important because like there are people who collect like skill chips we do. So if you do an activity, uh-huh. You get a poker chip.
Yeah.
And the poker chip is in theme. So when people have all of their collections together, they go, that was the dinosaur year. That was the elf year. That was the vampire year. And so it's just a really kind of like shorthand for what the year was. And that's kind of why we do it. And it helps when people are cosplaying. Like, you know what? I'm going to be a dinosaur this time. You know. Uh-huh. So we've seen a fair few of these.
Yeah, seen a few of the JMOs running around in dinosaur costumes. Yeah, I'm taking it that's not the Dinosaur Derby.
No. That's not quite the Dinosaur Derby. They do. I think it's the scene changes for the main event. We have a little dinosaur fight because, well, why wouldn't you?
Uh-huh. And you've had a number of different sort of big stage side events coming on as well. So out of the stuff you've got on this year, what's probably your highlight?
So we've already missed the cook-off, as you said, which was just messy. I really like the idea of Mythbusters. So we're doing something whereby players have just contributed all the things they assume about us.
Yeah.
You know, we're off in our kind of ivory tower. We you know, they've got some assumptions about who we are. So, you know... I'm trying to think of some ones that aren't just really rude. Most of these assumptions are rude about us. You know, we do some back. Like, we assume you play in your pants. Uh-huh. You know, and we're going to see how many of them throw up their hands.
I can confirm that I play in my pants. I mean, not mobile. That would not go down well in the commute. But I mean, other, you know, in front of the desktop, that's fine.
Yeah. But they've got kind of spicy thoughts of like what our next game is and stuff like that. So we'll just challenge those assumptions, say whether it's true or false, and try to be as honest as possible.
We'll get onto those questions later.
Yeah.
So talking of that, we were obviously here to look at what's coming up for RuneScape as well as old school RuneScape. Yeah. So what have we got coming up for RuneScape this next coming year?
Yeah, so we're in this awkward position where I'm having an interview on the show floor with people who don't know necessarily what we're going to announce, but we could still go into it. Like, they're playthroughing in our volcano area, archaeology, which is our new skill, and that's like a headliner for us because skills are really... how you like achieve in our game.
Yeah.
Instead of like classes or play or that kind of thing, really, you like double down, try to get to 99, level 99 in a given skill. And archaeology is great because it splits up into like four things. It's, you know, you're digging in the dirt, that's kind of a gathering skill, a little bit grindy. But then you're moving into the manufacturing, you're making artifacts, that kind of stuff, remaking them so they're powerful again.
Yeah.
And then you've got all of these dig sites and areas to explore in. I break the door open, so you know, when you're like finding Tutankhamun's tomb for the first time, you're in there, you're raiding it, that kind of thing. So then you get your little Nathan Drake on. And then also you got your rewards, and we're trying to bring in like, because most people do it for the rewards, right? We've got three new genres of rewards, which should make it
up. That's shiny loot, man.
Sorry?
I said, it's shiny loot. That's why I come here, for the swag, you said.
You say archaeology to me, and I start thinking, okay, now I can think of all the gold and stuff that I'm getting right here. Exactly. But we kind of subverted expectations a little bit, do a bit of D&D. So there are some unexpected rewards in there too. But that'll kick off at about 5 o'clock. Got the session that we go into that. We'll probably tell a little bit more about mobile.
So we can probably find that anyone watching this video can find more about archaeology once we've seen the event and we can actually write about it.
Yeah, we go on about a good 20 minutes, I'd say, in the keynote, diving into it, showing as much as possible.
So in terms of skills, because obviously RuneScape's been gone for a while and that means there's been a lot of skills come into the game. How do you go about designing and pulling together new skills for the game that are both... that incentivizes players to go for them and are relevant going through the game? Because as you progress, obviously, you don't want to make other skills completely irrelevant.
You're absolutely right. Yeah, to be honest, it was a long process. One of the biggest things, so we got together in a kind of week and just determined, because skills fires everybody up in our in our company. Like, that's the creative, gets the creative juices going. So we had 6 or 7. We had things like necromancy, sailing, spell crafting. We had a few on there, and we decided that we were going to throw them in front of the players. So we did a wee survey or a focus test on it with a small group of players. So that told us that necromancy and archaeology were like, people wanted those. But then you get into the design part. It's like, how big are those opportunities? Like, necromancy felt like it was doing a lot of stuff we've already got in another skill. Well, archaeology, we just thought it just threw open the doors to a lot of new things.
And is it important to use those sort of skills to thread it through not just the new areas of the game, but the old areas of the game?
It bleeds into everything. Useful? Yeah, yeah. The rewards are actually rewards for other skills in the game. So it just keeps that loop going. It feeds everything else. So that's when you're like 19, like 18 years old as a game as we are, it's got to be interrelated. You can't just throw something new in there.
And I suppose that's kind of especially relevant for RuneScape because the average length of service, possibly, of a RuneScape player is longer than you would normally get with other games. Yeah. Putting something like WoW aside, which is a very long player length as well, RuneScape is something like over 5 years on average for a player.
You're right, you're 7. Well done. Do you know what data?
Considering I saw that stat a couple of years ago, it
should probably update it.
So bearing that in mind, obviously, keeping skills, gear, crafting, other areas of the game that come in relevant, it's got to be especially important for a game that has such a long kind of history with its player base.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, one of the things that we're going to be doing in our keynote, which a lot of our players do know, is that we're going to be taking 2 more skills, raising their skill cap.
Yeah.
You're going to take them from 99 to 120. So that's one way that we do it. We're going to make sure that they're rich. There's a lot to play there. But for me, if you're going to be updating the game, it's also important to update the skills that players know and already value.
Yeah.
So, that's going to be a hype moment, hopefully, for the keynote.
So getting off of RuneScape and moving on to old school RuneScape, what can we expect from old school RuneScape?
Well,
coming
I feel
up?
Even more. I don't know how much I can reveal about their keynote because I don't actually work on old school. But they've got some fantastic announcements. Some things that people do know have already been announced. But we got updates on Group Iron Man, got updates on clans. There's some big stuff there. So that's going to be pretty hype. There's a lot of new things. It's really cinematic this year on our keynote.
Yeah.
We've decided to act, which is probably not wise.
I don't know. I think our director over there is definitely going to be looking to capture some of that.
It's just like, we are nerds. We're nerds behind our desks. We signed up to be code monkeys and things like that. We never expected to go out in the field and act and make films.
Yeah.
And we're very much going for that.
Looks like we're probably going to be out of the recording area right now. So what we're going to do is wrap up now. But thank you very much.
You're more than welcome.
Where can people go to find out more about RuneScape, old school RuneScape, and what's coming up with the game?
Absolutely. So our official YouTube and our forums are good places to find out more. And hopefully maybe we'll chat later on as well and maybe get some more updates. But
You caught us now as we've gone ahead and we've snuck off to our very own private guild hall so we can talk about some super secret stuff that hasn't quite come up at RuneScape yet, and unfortunately we were not stealthy enough to talk about it on the show floor, but that's why we got dragged off. It was the impending spoilers.
It was only polite, rather than talk about it from the players before they get to hear it. So thanks.
Well,
no, you know, it was the security guard was pretty threatening. I'm fairly sure that he was a higher level than us.
He had a thuggish face.
So obviously we're here to talk about a few things that we couldn't talk about out in public.
Yes.
So why don't you just spoil
it? No, I can just spoil this. I feel like released. One of the big ones is our mobile early access. Uh-huh. We're going to be hitting this year. So the ability for any member to come and play RuneScape Mobile.
So that's a huge thing, RuneScape Mobile coming up. We've had old school mobile for a while now, but that's in terms of the project,
yeah,
it's got to be a huge step from the old school game up to the current iteration of RuneScape.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not saying that old school is a port by any means, but it was far easier to put it onto a phone. But with RuneScape, because of the sheer amount of additional UI elements, mm-hmm, the additional complexity that come from the number of years since old school, it's been so much more difficult. But uh-huh, it's a new game almost, in the sense that it's so much slicker, there's so much in there to uh-huh improve it. And one of the things that we're going to be announcing in the keynote that makes that even better, amplifies it even more, is we've got a bit of a tech showcase.
Uh-huh.
I know, yeah, our CEO, Mopips, will be taking us through some of the things we're going to be doing with the core engine and platform, so it mm-hmm just feels like frictionless. Mm-hmm. So things we're doing with the tick, because then how often the game updates,
yeah,
things we're doing with smooth movement, how the player moves about the grid in our game, yep, those kind of things are all just going to become slick as anything. It's going to be lovely.
So in terms of the RuneScape game itself, are we going to see the same version of RuneScape on mobile as we are on desktop? Are we looking at the same iteration of it, or are we seeing the game splice off into
it's
two
a bit
different
of a
games?
Mix. Yeah, so some players are obviously so used to their desktop layouts and how they play with the game, they've been playing it in the same routines for so long.
Yeah.
So we've got to be very careful what we bring over, but so much of what we're doing on mobile is beneficial to desktop. So,
yeah,
you know, like for example, a couple of weeks ago, we vastly optimised the loading time for the game.
Yeah.
You know, like almost three times as fast getting in the game. Of course, we're going to bring that to desktop. And that was something we did for mobile. So that's a no-brainer. But yeah, some things will drift over.
So definitely, it sounds like there's been more technical challenges and more compromises that had to be made for the platform change with coming into the mobile space.
It's something we've actually dedicated. We've got three big teams, and one of them is dedicated to game feel. And we've never done that before. We've done kind of pick and mix projects about kind of modernising the game, but this is the first time we've really gone at it for the jugular. So, and just really looking to improve an older game.
So when can players who are already members expect to be able to jump into the beta for this?
Well, it is this year. That's all we can say at the moment. I wish I could give a date. But pending.
So have you had a chance to play it on mobile yet?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, absolutely. You know, it's my responsibility as lead designer to play everything that we release on mobile as well.
Of course.
So yeah, it's got to feel good on mobile. But yeah.
You excited for it?
Yeah, I said I want to play on the loo. Of course I want to. You know, I go on the bus every day to work. I don't want to look at people. I want to make XP games.
That brings a new meaning to the idea of hunting dinosaur poop.
Yeah, that's right.
Anyway, moving on from that farming metaphor. So, other than that big moment in RuneScape history, I'd say, what else can we expect coming from either RuneScape or RuneScape
like
that we can talk about in our super secret private game club?
No, we're up in the offices. I feel I underserved old school. So there's some stuff that I feel more happy to talk about now, like, for example, they're unleashing a new city.
Yeah.
So they have Dartmare, which, Dartmare is a vampire city.
Yeah.
They've got... this one is that's already in RuneScape, but they've got their own version of it.
Uh-huh.
And there's raiding the catacombs and an agility kind of mini game while vampires are trying to get at you. It's really quite fun. They've got a quest that is the Madness of Ashen Armor, I think it's called, which is very much trying to mess with you.
Yes.
Kind of a psychological horror quest, which, you know, is always good fun to make.
Yeah.
Always want to make one of those. And I said previously, they've really gone through it with a clan system.
Yeah.
Old school is one of the most social games you'll find, and there's not actually a canonical, properly designed clan system in there.
Yeah, it very much reflects itself in the Deadman mode, with the fact that you have a lot of clans outside of the game that will tend to kind of work together for the Deadman mode to get one player.
You're spot on. Yeah, absolutely. So it's already naturally, organically, people are coming together.
Yeah.
But what the work we can do with clans, and that comes with everything, you know, like all the clan permissions, all the clan systems of broadcasting, things you can do as a clan. We can also do for Group Iron Man.
Yep.
So our game now recommends connect accounts together for clans,
yep,
which means we can do that for Group Iron Man. And what Group Iron Man is the ability to set up an account that cannot trade with others. So everything you do is for yourself. But with Grip Line Man, you're doing it with for others. You are all embarking on this hardcore version of the game together.
And how many players are we looking at in those Grip Iron Man?
Well, in Iron Man as current, 1 in 5 counts Iron.
Yeah.
So you can see, like, a lot of people want to do this, like, really test themselves, on a kind of survival mode-esque thing for old school. So we can, you know, if we even get half of that, I'll be really chuffed. People will look and set up that account and do it.
There's obviously tons and tons coming from both RuneScape and old school. So what we will do is we're going to go ahead and we're going to wrap things up now, similarly, because if we keep talking, we're basically going to overrun your event in the auditorium. But what we'll do is if you check out MMORPG, we're going to break these down, let you know what's coming, and we'll probably see you on RuneScape Mobile. I've certainly got enough time on my commute to go ahead and do so. So thanks again for watching, and we'll see you again soon.
Thank you.